Hi, I'm Kyle Marsh from the Identity and Network Access Group here at Microsoft. And in this video, I want to talk about, well, the on behalf of foe, but really the question of mixing delegated and application permissions. Now, this is always an area of concern for me. When I see an application that's asking for both types, I immediately want to question why. Most often this happens when one API needs to call another. It always requires additional scrutiny because if I have an application that's signing in a user, getting a delegated access token, sending that off to the to an API, and then that API in turn is saying I need an application permission in order to call the downstream API, or even if I have an application that's doing the same thing, where I sign in the user but then call, say, Microsoft Graph with an application permission, that application now has the opportunity to allow a user to do something that the user otherwise would not have been allowed to do, because the application has to enforce any and all the user permission kinds of access questions, and it's highly unlikely the application may not know everything, all of the rules that dictate that. So it's always a concern for me when an application goes and tries to mix those two together. In the case of an application, it's pretty straightforward. Simply, you should be using delegated access permissions to call that other the other API on behalf of your assigned in user. On an API, it gets a little more complicated because I can't go back to the user and ask them to grant consent for me to get a token to another API. So when one API calls another, what happens is, so I have my Your API here on the right. It gets a token from the calling application that allows that calling application to access the Your API. Inside of that API as a delegated application token, a delegated permission token rather, will be the identity of the user, and the Your API will go ahead, check the access token is valid, check the user is constrained within what the user is allowed to do, and if everything's correct, it will go ahead and proceed. Now let's say as part of that procedure, the API wants to call a Microsoft Graph API. Now it really should be calling Microsoft Graph on behalf of the user for whom it has its access token, and not on behalf of the API itself, because again, that leaves the opportunity the user can access something they're not supposed to. So to solve this, the API goes to Azure Active Directory directly, and it provides two things. First off, it provides the access token that it was given that allowed the client application to call the API on behalf of a particular user whose identity is embedded in that access token, and it needs a client credential showing that it is in fact the entity that owns this token, that is, that knows the secrets for the app that's registered, that creates the audience, if you will, of that token. So now Azure AD can do everything it usually does when it issues a new access token. It can check that consent has been granted. We would advise the original application to use the .default scope when asking for permission to the Your API API set. That way, we will check to see if there are any additional downstream API permissions that are needed, like, for example, to Microsoft Graph, and that happens up front when the user is first prompted for consent. So assuming consent is good, the conditional access policies are correct, then Azure AD can go ahead and issue a token for the API to call Microsoft Graph on behalf of the original user who signed into the application. So at this point, it's a standard access token that can simply be provided to the Microsoft Graph API, and now Microsoft Graph is the one who's figuring out, is this user actually allowed access, because the user's identity is embedded in that token. They can check, Microsoft Graph can check, if this user is truly allowed to do whatever operation that is being requested. So the enforcement lives where it's supposed to, in the Microsoft Graph API, and not in your custom API or some other place. So assuming the token's good, the claims are good, then the Microsoft Graph API will work as it's supposed to. So you should definitely avoid mixing delegated and application permissions in your applications and APIs. Applications are pretty straightforward. Always ask for an access token on behalf of the user. For APIs, you do have to do a little bit more, and you have to use the on behalf of flow whenever one API calls another API in a delegated permission scenario. So I encourage you to make sure and check into using things like the on behalf of flow and always avoid mixing delegated and application permissions. Thanks, and enjoy the rest of your day.